He has to rise. Today, we are discussing about exponential and logarithmic functions. Exponential functions. Exponential function. And logarithmic function. A function is of the form y is equal to e raised to x or e raised to x. Is an exponential function. There are so many exponential functions we have. They are the derivative of such functions are e raised to x of e raised to x. E raised to x is e raised to x. The derivative of e raised to minus x. That is minus e raised to minus x. The derivative of a raised to x, that is a raised to x into u dA. The derivative of x raised to a into x raised to a minus 1. Here x is the base and a is a constant. Similarly, d by dx of x raised to n. N into x raised to n minus 1 d by dx of a raised to a, both exponent and base are constants, so its derivative is 0. So d by dx of, so a raised to x, a constant, x exponent, x raised to a, x of base and exponent is a constant. The base is a constant, exponent is a function of x. The base is a function of x and exponent is a constant. Base function of x, exponent constant. Base constant, exponent is also a constant. Now, x raised to x. X raised to x and x raised to x. Base is a function of x and exponent is also a function of x. In this case, we find a derivative in another way, that is known as logarithmic function theory of theorem of logarithmic function. You see. We can find the derivative in logarithmic function method. Exponential functions are somewhat similar, and we can find the derivative. Let us take some examples. V is equal to e raised to x squared plus 1. The function is in the form function of a function. So dy by dx is equal to e raised to x square plus 1 and find the derivative of x square plus 1, that is 2x plus 1, 2x plus 0. So the answer is 2x e raised to x square plus 1. Is it right? 2x into e raised to x squared plus 1. Another function, v is equal to e raised to root x. Here divided by dx is equal to e raised to root x into log a into d by dx of x, that is d by dx of a raised to x is a raised to x into log a. So the function is in the form a raised to x, a raised to x, that is a raised to x into log a into d by dx of root x. Root x is function of the function, that is a raised to root x into log a into 1 by 2 root x. This is that. Instead, if we see correct 2 raised into root x, then we have dy by dx is equal to 2 raised to root x into log 2 into 1 by 2 root x. Isn't it? Instead of a, here the radius is 2. Let us discuss the derivative of logarithmic function. A function is of the form O is equal to log x. Log x means log x to the base e. Log x to the base e. In calculus, natural logarithms are used. So, base of the logarithm is e. Dy by dx of is equal to log x of is 1 by x. Log x means log x to the base e is 1 by x. If d by dx of log x of to the base a, suppose the base is a, then we have to convert it into base e logarithm. So log x to the base e divided by log a to the base e. This product is known as base change in log m to the base n is equal to log m to the base b divided by log n to the base. This is base change in log. Here we use the base as e because in calculus natural logarithms are used. This base is e. Now log a is a constant. Now this function can be written as d by dx of log x divided by log a. But log a is a constant, so 1 by log a is a constant into d by dx of log x. We know the derivative of log x is 1 by x, so the answer is 1 by log a into 1 by x. So the final answer will be 1 divided by x log a is the answer. Log x to the base e, similarly we can say that log x is derivative is 1 by x, but if the base is other than e, then we have to use base changing rule and then find the derivative. Okay. Now problems involving loss of logarithms. Find dy by dx if v is equal to sin x, sin 2x, sin 10x, product of three functions. Here applying log on both sides, log o is equal to log sin x sin 2x sin 10x. But log abc is log abc is log a plus log b plus log c. Log AB is log A plus log B. Log ABC is log A plus log B plus log C. So here it becomes log sin X plus log sin 2X plus log sin X. this now differentiating with respect to sum becomes a implicit function. So differentiating with respect to x, derivative of rho is 1 by y into derivative of y is dy by dx. Derivative of log x is derivative of log x d by dx of log x is 1 by x. D by dx of log y means we cannot find the derivative of log y with respect to x. So convert this function d by dy of log y into, to eliminate this dy, multiply by dy and this dx of, you cancel the dx here. D by dy of log y is 1 by y into, then we have 1 d by dx. Derivative of log y is 1 by y into d by dx, this way is equal to log sin x. What about log sin x is 1 by sin x into sin x is cos x. Then log sin 2x 1 by sin 2x into sin 2x is cos 2x into 2x is 2. Function of a function of a function we have studied. And log sin 3x 1 by sin 3x into derivative of sin 3x is cos 3x into 3x is 3x. Now we can transfer this way to the numerator, cross multiply. Therefore, dy by dx is equal to y into cos by sin cot x plus 2 cot 2x plus 3 cot 3x. And find the answer will be substituting the value of y in, we have sin x sin 2x sin 3x into cot x plus 2 cot 2x plus 3 cot 3x. This is the answer. So sin x, sin 2x, sin. Similarly, we can find the derivative of cos x, cos 2x, cos 3x, cos 4x, sin x, sin 2x, sin 3x, sin 4. Any number of functions can be extended. Using this logarithmic principle, we can find the derivatives. Try yourself. Another question. We see one. X plus 1 into x plus 2 the whole square 1 x minus 3 the whole raised to 2. I am taking such convex algebraic forms can be easily differentiated by logarithmic function. Here we take log on both sides, so log y is equal to log square root of x plus 1 into x plus 2 the whole square by x minus 3 the whole cube. But log root x is half log x. Log root x is half log x. Log ab by c is, now one more rule, log ab by c is log a plus log b minus log c. Here no rule is used. Log m raised to n is m log n. For 3 logarithmic forms are used here. Here log y is log root x half log x. So half in log x plus 1 in x plus 2 whole square by x minus 10 the whole cube. Isn't it? Now log AB by C. Half in log, half is common. Log AB by C is log A, log x plus 1 plus log x plus 2 the whole square minus log x minus 3 the whole cube. Now last result is used, log n raised to p, log n raised to p, and n log n, so half into log x plus 1 plus 2 log x plus 2 minus 3 log x minus 3. Now it is an implicit function, so we can directly differentiate it with respect to x. What about log y? 1 by y into dy by dx. 1 by y into dy by dx is equal to half is a constant. Derivative of log x is 1 by x, 1 by x plus 1 into derivative x plus 1 is 1 plus 2 into log x plus 2, 1 by x plus 2. The derivative x plus 2, it is again 1 minus 3 into 1 by x minus 3, and the derivative x minus 3 is again 1. Now cross multiply y in. Dy by dx is equal to y into half into y into half into here 1 by x plus 1 plus 2 by x plus 2 minus 3 by x minus. The value of y is root of, that is half into root of x plus 1 into x plus 2 the whole square by x minus 3 the whole cube into 1 by x plus 1 plus 2 by x plus 2 minus 3 by x minus 3. This is the derivative of this function. These functions are purely based on logarithmic rules. There are certain rules in logarithms. Using that rules, we can find the derivative of such functions. Logarithmic functions have many problems. The second part will explain some more logarithmic functions and its derivatives. Okay.